A reverse proxy is like a middleman that takes requests from the clients and sends them to the backend servers. The clients could be web browsers, mobile applications, or even internal microservices. Reverse proxies help to increase scalability, performance, resilience, and security of your infrastructure. A reverse proxy is transparent to the client, and it would appear that resource returned to the client originated from the backend server itself. Now, in order to better understand how a reverse proxy works and the benefits it can provide, let's first define what a proxy server is. A forward proxy, often called a proxy server, or web proxy, is a server that sits in front of a group of client machines. When those computers make requests to the websites and services on the internet, the proxy server intercepts those requests and then communicates with web servers on behalf of those clients, like a middleman. In standard internet communication, your computer directly reaches out to the server, with the client sending requests to the origin server and the origin server responding to the client. When a forward proxy is in place, your computer sends requests to the forward proxy server, which then forwards the request to the origin server. The origin server then sends a response back to the proxy server, which in turn forwards the response back to your computer. Now, let's talk about why anyone would want to use extra middlemen when browsing the internet. First of all, it's a common practice for large organizations, public schools, and universities to use forward proxies. They could use a proxy to block students or employees from visiting certain websites, such as Facebook, YouTube, and others. Forward proxies can also be used to monitor employee online activity. A proxy can record every single website that you visit, and then your employer can check what you're actually doing during working hours. Also, it can be used to improve security. For example, if the host computer is infected with a virus, the proxy can be configured to only whitelist certain resources on the internet. And if that virus wants to send data back to the hacker, the proxy can potentially block it. A proxy can also be used to improve user experience by caching external content. This will make the page load much faster the next time you visit the website, or if anyone else has already visited that website before you. It can also be used to protect your online identity. When you visit a website, the connection is established from the proxy server. This means only the proxy's IP address will be visible to the server, and any application on that server trying to track your activity will get IP address used not only by you, but by others behind that proxy. In this way, it's more difficult to identify you. It's similar to a VPN. Also, it can be used to avoid some restrictions placed on you by your employer or a school. Some governments, schools, and other organizations use firewalls to give their users access to a limited version of the internet. A forward proxy can be used to get around these restrictions, as it lets the user connect to the proxy rather than directly to the sites they are visiting. A reverse proxy is a server that sits in front of one or more web servers, intercepting requests from clients. This is different from a forward proxy, where the proxy sits in front of the clients. With a reverse proxy, when clients send requests to the origin server of a website, those requests are intercepted at the network edge by the reverse proxy server. The reverse proxy server will then send requests to and receive responses from the origin server. The difference between a forward and reverse proxy is small but important. A simplified way would be to say that forward proxy sits in front of client and ensures that no origin server ever communicates directly with that specific client. On the other hand, a reverse proxy sits in front of origin server and ensures that no client ever communicates directly with that specific origin server. Typically, all requests from your computer will go directly to the server, and the the server would send responses directly back to you. With a reverse proxy, all requests from your computer go directly to the reverse proxy, and that proxy sends its requests to and receive responses from the origin server. The reverse proxy then passes along the appropriate responses to you. Keep in mind that a reverse proxy must terminate the TCP connection and create a new one towards your origin server. This means your server will not get IP of the client in case your server needs to know who exactly initiated the request. In that case, you would need to configure your proxy to send the client's IP address in the header or use a proxy protocol. Now, let's talk about why would you want to use a reverse proxy. First of all, you can use a reverse proxy to load balance traffic between multiple servers. Usually, popular websites such as Google, Facebook, ChatGPT receive thousands of requests per second. To handle all these requests, companies need to maintain a pool of servers. A reverse proxy can distribute the incoming traffic evenly among the different servers to prevent any single server from becoming overloaded. In the event that a server fails completely, other servers can step up to handle the traffic. Some proxies have passive health checks, meaning the proxy will remove a server from the pool only after it fails a request. Other proxies, or sometimes commercial versions such as Nginx Plus, have active health checks. These checks are proactive and discover failed servers before sending requests to them. Also, reverse proxies are used for version upgrades, allowing them to be performed without downtime. So you can roll out a new version behind the proxy and start to send a small amount of traffic to those servers. If there are no issues, you can roll out the update to the rest of the servers. This type of deployment is known as canary deployment. Additionally, in case there is an issue, you can immediately revert back to the old version. This is possible because clients interact directly with the proxy. They only need to know its hostname and don't need to worry about changes to the backend network topology. Next, reverse proxies provide protection from attacks. With a reverse proxy in place, a website or service never needs to reveal the IP address of the origin servers. This makes it much harder for attackers to leverage a targeted attack against them, such as a DDoS attack. Instead, attackers will only be able to target the reverse proxy, such as Cloudflare's CDN, which will have tighter security and more resources to protect against a cyber attack. In addition, some reverse proxies provide a web application firewall, WAF. While a regular network firewall usually operates at OSI layers 3 and 4, focusing on network protocols such as TCP, UDP, DNS, FTP, SMTP, SSH, and Telnet. You can block clients based on their IP address, the type of the protocol, and the port they use in the request. A web application firewall operates at OSI layer 7, which is the application layer. This includes attacks against applications like Ajax, ActiveX, and JavaScript, as well as cookie manipulation, SQL injection, and URL attacks. They also target web application protocols, HTTP and HTTPS, which are used to connect web browsers and web servers. For example, a layer 7 DDoS attack sends a flood of traffic to the server layer, where web pages are generated and delivered in response to the HTTP requests. A WAF mitigates this by acting as a reverse proxy that protects the targeted server from malicious traffic and filters requests to identify the use of DDoS tools. Some proxies provide global server load balancing. In this form of load balancing, a website can be distributed across several servers around the globe, and the reverse proxy will direct clients to the server that's geographically closest to them. This decreases the distances that the requests and responses need to travel, minimizing load times. Another way is to improve user experience is through caching. A reverse proxy can also cache content, resulting in faster performance. For example, if a user in London visits a reverse proxied website with web servers in Los Angeles, the user might actually connect to a local reverse proxy server in London, which will then communicate with a region server in LA. The proxy server can then cache or temporarily save the response data. Subsequent London users who browse the site will then receive the local cached version from the London reverse proxy server, resulting in much faster performance. In some instances, you can use compression to reduce latency. The proxy can compress the content, for example, using XIP. This will reduce the amount of data that needs to be transferred to you, resulting in a faster page load. Now, encrypting and decrypting TLS communications for each client can be computationally expensive for a region server. A reverse proxy can be configured to decrypt all incoming requests and encrypt all outgoing responses, freeing up valuable resources on the region server. Also, if you have different applications responsible for different URLs, for example, a shipping URL handled by shipping microservice and a login page by another microservice, this allows you to configure TLS in one place, rather than reconfiguring it for every single service individually. In some environments, like development or staging, where resources are limited, you may need to run multiple microservices on a single server. You can start different services on different ports. In that case, the reverse proxy can be used to map different URLs to different ports on the same server with the same IP address. With a reverse proxy, you can perform A/B testing without changing anything on the web page or in the JavaScript code. For example, you can configure the proxy to return different versions of your application based on the header in the request. And finally, you can add access authentication to a website that does not have any authentication. For example, you can configure Nginx to use basic authentication and require a username and a password in order to view the web page.